A hostage situation at Hamburg Airport in Germany has ended after 18 hours. It started after a 35-year-old man drove through the airport tarmac with his 4-year-old daughter and parked under a Turkish Airlines plane. He eventually surrendered without resistance. Hamburg police said the man was distraught over custody arrangements and he wanted to travel to Turkey with his child. The incident caused the disruption of several flights. Normal operations have since resumed. A caravan of hundreds of migrants left the southern Mexican city of Tapachula heading for the U.S. southern border. They plan to join a larger caravan waiting for them further north. The large caravan has swelled to some 7,000 migrants. These migrants hail from Cuba, El Salvador, Haiti, Honduras, and Venezuela, fleeing poverty and political instability. A stricter asylum policy, though, awaits them at the U.S. border. They must secure an appointment via an app before they can set foot on America. Search and rescue efforts have been called off in Nepal as a death toll from last week's earthquake rises to 158. Officials say they will now shift their focus on providing much-needed aid to survivors. The 6.4 magnitude quake struck Friday night. The tremor was also reportedly felt in India's capital, New Delhi. The quake is the deadliest since 2015, when about 9,000 people were killed in two earthquakes that struck the country. Israel ramps up its assault on Hamas encircling Gaza City and further deepening operations there. Israel's military claimed it has divided the besieged enclave into two, cutting off the northern part of the strip from the south. This also comes as the Palestinian telecom company Paltel reported another communication outage in the strip. Earlier on Sunday, Israeli warplanes struck two central Gaza refugee camps, killing at least 50 people. Israel maintains it would press on with its offensive until hostages are returned.
I want you to know that there's one thing that we won't do. There won't be a ceasefire without the return of our hostages. Take it completely out of the lexicon. We say it to our enemies and to our friends, and we'll simply carry on until we win. We don't have an alternative.
Well, the scheduled evacuation of foreigners, including 20 Filipinos from the besieged Gaza Strip, has been delayed. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department says the delay was due to attacks along the route that crosses into Egypt. The evacuation was originally planned for Sunday, but the DFA said it may be rescheduled for today, Monday. Out of the 134 Filipinos in the besieged enclave, 115 are waiting to cross the border. Washington's top diplomat ramping up efforts to ease tensions in the Middle East. Antony Blinken paid an unannounced visit to Iraq Sunday, his first in the country as U.S. Secretary of State. His visit comes after Iraqi armed groups warned Washington against supporting Israel in its war against Hamas. The U.S. wants to prevent a wider regional conflict as more countries protest Israel's attacks on Gaza.
Israel's raised important questions about how humanitarian pauses would work. We've got to answer those questions. We're working on exactly that. In fact, we agreed that our teams would get together, and they're doing just that, including today, to work through the specifics, the practicalities of these pauses. Second, it's important that the pause advance a number of things. One of them is hostages. We are intensely focused, the United States, Israel, every other country that has one of its citizens being held hostage by Hamas, to bring them home. It can also advance other things that we're committed to doing, especially getting more humanitarian assistance to people who need it in Gaza.
After Iraq, Blinken went to Turkey to meet with top officials there. Turkey earlier recalled its ambassador to Israel amid sustained bombings in Gaza. An Israeli strike on a car in South Lebanon kills 3 children and their grandmother. Lebanon state-owned media said the strike occurred near the border with Israel, where Israel and Hamas' ally Hezbollah have been trading fire since the war erupted. Meanwhile, Israel's army asserts attacks in Lebanon undergo thorough planning before being executed.
Regarding Lebanon, we attack on the basis of intelligence information and we will continue to attack. That is our mission. Anyone who threatens us, we will attack them. And every event, of course, that occurs in Lebanon, we examine it, and learn about it to understand the details. That's what I can say at this point.
Pope Francis once again calling for a ceasefire in the Gaza Strip. He also called for humanitarian aid for those affected. The pontiff also called for the release of hostages taken by Hamas. A Gaza health official said more than 9,700 Palestinians have been killed in the war.
I keep thinking about the grave situation in Palestine and Israel, where so many people have lost their lives. Please stop in the name of God. Ceasefire. I hope that all will be done to avoid the conflict from widening, that the injured will be rescued and aid will arrive to the population of Gaza, where the humanitarian situation is very grave. Hostages must be freed immediately, among them many children, and returned to their families.
A painting by French Impressionist Claude Monet set to go under the hammer this month, the first in decades. The Willows Giverny dates back to 1886 and has remained in private hands since 1948. Monet found solace in Giverny, west of Paris. That's from 1883 until his death in 1926, where he transformed a pink stucco house into his permanent home and studio, growing a Japanese-style garden across a pond of water lilies, which inspired many of his paintings.
It's a big deal, because paintings of Claude Monet of this scale, of this dimension, no longer really exist among French families today. They're found mostly in big museums or in foreign collections. It's very rare to find them in France. It's a big occasion for the French market.
Though not as famous as his other works, the Willows Giverny bears the artist's trademark style and is expected to fetch up to 3 million euros. Well, here's a blast from the past. The original members of the iconic 90s rock band River Maya reuniting for a concert next year. To be more specific, the much-anticipated show will happen February 17th at the SMDC Festival grounds. Find out how you can get tickets to the River Maya reunion concert by heading on over to news.abs-cbn.com.